Hello, everyone. I am Dr. Francisco. So what can you do to take better care of your diabetes? For those who tune for the first time, I am Dr. Francisco. I am a specialist nephrologist and a transplant immunologist working at Francisco Kidney and Medical Center in Singapore. This is the bite-sized information for kidney and related diseases. And this video blog is destined to help patients with kidney problems or at risk of kidney problems or their relatives to be better informed so they can take better care of their disease, minimizing worries and complications. They can do that with their own doctor or with me if they choose me. So what can you do to take better care of your diabetes? In the previous videos, we discussed how significant or problematic diabetic kidney disease or diabetes by itself can be. And I pointed that the center of the solution lies on self-care, having as a basis diet and lifestyle changes, and not relying solely on medications. Importantly, many people can be treated solely with diet control. And it is not controlling the diet, actually, the main factor involved in disease appearance, disease progression, and potential complications in diabetic patients. What I mean is, the origin of diabetes is actually not having a good diet and lifestyle. And then the origin of many of these complications is carry on in the same way. So this is the main aspect that needs to be targeted for preventing or treating this disease. So healthier diet and lifestyle can not only help you treat diabetes better and prevent complications, but if implemented early, people who are at risk can help them avoiding the development of diabetes. It can also, someone with pre-diabetes, help them revert into a normalized state. Someone with metabolic syndrome can also help them to prevent into develop diabetes and many other diseases that surround metabolic syndrome, cardiovascular disease, etc. So it is very impactful. But I gather that it seems not so simple for many to incorporate diet changes in their lifestyle, but it is also not impossible. I did it when I thought I couldn't. I ended up losing 10 kilograms and I have sustained it for almost 3 years already using my own methods. In my clinic, we are proud to help patients to include sustainable, that's the important word, sustainable, and the other one is doable changes in their diet and lifestyle, impacting significantly their condition because we provide the right advice, support, and strategies that anyone can do as long as decide to do an active change and commitment to introduce new changes in the diet and lifestyle. I have heard so many times that diet doesn't work. No, diet works perfectly, but what is not working is the method, the strategy to implement it, to rush it in your lifestyle. But if don't gradually target it to the hot points when there is a problem with the right support, coaching, strategies, that it can actually be implemented in your lifestyle. And we just do it like that in Francisco Kidney Medical Center and in my other company that is called Olympia Lifestyle of Dr. Francisco. This is our specialty. So it is possible. And I have patients that have just controlled diabetes from 12.5 HbA1c into 6.5 with only diet. Only insulin can do that. So, and they didn't need to go into crazy restrictions. You just need to do little changes here and there where the hot points are and just keep doing it and be patient, allow the body to adapt. Slow motion, but solidly in a good direction, and the changes eventually happen. you're not going to change your frequency like that, because obviously it takes months to see the change, but eventually you can get it. I didn't get 10 kilograms of weight loss in 1 month as all the other programs promise you, and then you just hate that restrictive diet and you just go back. It took me 8 or 9 months, but because I decided to do it gradually. But then my body adapted, I didn't suffer it. I received a lot of benefits of that. I have kept it for almost 3 years, minimizing my risk for future diseases or things like that. Just the same thing I do with my clients and patients. So, okay, there was a little bit of parenthesis. Let's discuss some tips. None of them on diet, so I not only talk about diet and lifestyle, but this is the center because it's usually the source of the problems I already mentioned. And if managed, the basis is well managed, adding medications when needed or other strategies is just enhance things. But if the basis are, you know, shaky or not followed, is when it is very difficult to treat well a disease, and is when the complications start coming and coming and coming, and eventually disabilities or a shorter lifespan that I don't want for my patients. That's why I always advise them, and what is the best, and that is self-care, diet, lifestyle, and when needed, yes, medications, when needed, treatment, but not just focusing on treating straight away when there are, you know, better, healthier steps before that. Yeah, anyway, so, but also I have some tips on how you can manage the diabetes better, and also those measures can help you for your overall health. Okay, so let's start. I have a pointer just for remind me, I go in order. I have 20 pieces of advice for you. Let's go one by one. Number one, if you have excessive weight, you need to aim to lose it. And actually, the best way to lose weight is by improving your diet. You can do exercise as a complementary strategy, but the fundamentals, the basis, the most impactful strategy is to improve your diet. And there are many ways to do it, but as I told you, in my companies, we do it in a more strategic, personalized way, so in a way more effective and sustainable without suffering, etc. But that's one of the things that you should aim to target to get overall better health and to control your diabetes better. If you have excessive weight, you should aim to get rid of those kilograms, not just control the number, because many people just, okay, increase the insulin, increase the medications, and then you can bring down a little bit the number or more or less there, but still the source of the matter, the diet has not been improved, the excessive weight, the metabolic order, metabolic derangement, and the metabolic syndrome is still present. No, you need to treat it holistically from the basis and then go into adding whatever it is needed. Yeah? Okay. So let's go to number two. I already alluded. You can control better your diabetes if you start introducing some exercise. A little bit of exercise is okay, but obviously more moderate exercise if you don't have any heart problems or any respiratory problems or any significant disability is possible. But doesn't mean that if you have something like that, that you cannot do exercise. That means that you probably have to have a tailored exercise regimen for you with a green light and the blessing from your cardiologist or other doctor. And that's why the rehab teams, the physiotherapists, and the exercise physiologists exist, to allow anyone, irrespective of age, disability, injuries, degree of conditioning, body composition, weight, etc., to be able to benefit from exercise. But do consult a specialist, like a heart doctor, or if you have a heart problem especially. And remember that people with kidney failure or with diabetes can have a heart problem without them knowing it. Or sometimes the symptoms might be silent in diabetic patients. So in a way, do consult your doctor. It can be initially your nephrologist and he will advise you. But if you have a known heart problem, your heart doctor. But that doesn't mean if you have kidney failure means that you cannot do exercise, or if you have heart disease, you cannot exercise. It's not true. You still need to, but depending what is the degree, the severity, etc. So that's why you just need to do it strategically according to your condition, personalized. Get advice from an expert, a physiotherapist, rehab, and from a doctor. Yeah. But if you are, apart from diabetes, you don't have any major issue or medical condition, you should do a little bit of exercise, light to moderate, with no major problems. But again, gradually increase the exercise so your body adapt, and you discover if your body can, you know, cope with it, rather than just rushing in and then discover something. And as I always say, the doctor's prescription typically is like 5 days a week for at least 30 minutes a day. It can be just walking, you can go to the gym, can be cycling, can be running. You can do it at home following Zumba or Strongbee videos. It doesn't matter as long as you move. But it's another way for you to control diabetes. The one I mentioned before is very obvious, the diet, no? Because it's the sugar and many carbs in there. This one, because, you know, at the end of the day, you can help, it can help you reducing your weight, but also because it improves your sugar metabolism. Your muscles work a little bit more, can absorb more sugar. So the sugar doesn't remain for long time in the bloodstream. Also, you have a little more muscle. If you combine also aerobic and a little bit of resistance exercise, you will have more muscle mass, so meaning more receptors for sugar, and that also enhances your insulin sensitivity, meaning reduces your insulin resistance. That is one of the main problems in type 2 diabetes, or when people have metabolic syndrome, excessive weight, etc. So apart from give you other multitude of benefits in, you know, making your heart, your lungs stronger, making your bones, joints, muscles stronger, improving your mood, etc. A lot of benefits. So number two was doing exercise. Let's go to number three, that ideally, although it's not sugar per se, but aim to reduce fried, fatty, oily food. Especially reduce a large amount of saturated fats, and definitely try to avoid this so-called trans fat, that is an artificial type of fat, because that it kind of supposedly hardens more the blood vessels and the atherosclerotic plaques. So in a way, try to minimize that, because many of these eventually can derange your metabolism, can increase your weight, and they are not good for your heart. Remember, diabetes is not just blood sugar. Diabetes is the risk for heart disease and many other complications. All these are, as a whole, cardiovascular diseases. The vascular system is ill, is suffering when you don't control very well your diet, you have excessive weight, when your blood sugar goes high, when your fatty acids, your lipids go high, etc., when your uric acid, all your cardiovascular system suffers, all the blood vessels, and the heart, the brain, the eyes, the kidneys, the legs, the male genitals, etc., depend on blood vessels. So that's why the main complications happen in those organs. So remember, and when I tell you all this advice, not just to take care of your diabetes, but take care as a whole of yourself when you have diabetes. And not just focusing on sugar, focus on everything that you can do to enhance your health. And that's one of the problems I have seen, that, you know, some doctors and some patients just focus in control the diabetes, control the sugar, bring it down with medications or whatever, but forget about the rest of aspects that, you know, that could be the blood pressure, the smoking, sedentary life. And it's important to see from the basis, but also see our patients as a whole, and also see yourself as a whole, that you need to take every single aspect that you think is deranged in your life, and then you will receive much benefit. You don't want to just take care of diabetes if eventually there are other problems that can normally harm your health better. You need to do it everything as a whole, and it will be more benefit. So number four, if you have high blood cholesterol, you might need also some more targeted diet intervention, but some patients also might need cholesterol tablets. So just consider that. Talk to your doctor also for the cholesterol tablets. You need to talk to your doctor. But because I am very pro into diet and lifestyle, many of my patients, we always give a trial on diet first, and if not, yes, go to cholesterol tablets, not just go straight to the cholesterol tablets. And many of my patients actually, it's also their personality. They don't want to take just medications, you know. They don't want to put so many chemicals on their body. They ask already to give them, you know, diet and lifestyle advice. And they, if the thing doesn't work, then jump to that. So let's go to number five. So that one, if you smoke, sincerely, sincerely, sincerely stop smoking. We already talked that it can be very difficult in other videos, in my other company. I have a Facebook group there also about giving advice for health enhancement, weight loss specifically. I know it is very difficult, but everything starts by someone wanting it to do it, wanted to do a change, to decide to change his own label from a smoker to a non-smoker, and then start doing all the things that non-smokers do. Indeed, there are other strategies, medications or chewing with nicotine, etc., that can help you to bear the process in a better way. But at the end, the people who more effectively quit smoking, it is the ones who just decide to quit from one day to another. But if you say, oh, I'm not going to quit smoking, it's going to be very difficult, I'm going to suffer, etc., and then you give up today the smoke, you maybe 30 minutes later, you will go back. No, you say, yes, I know it's going to be difficult, I'm going to do whatever is necessary for that, I have this strategy, that support, I call this expert, etc., whatever, but I'm going from today onward label myself as a person that has quit smoking. And I'm going to do everything that a person who doesn't smoke do. That is, throw away those cigarettes, don't go and buy cigarettes, don't go and to the meeting with a friend that is smoking there. And then it's going to work more effectively, especially because you said to yourself, because this is what I want and I need for my life from now on. Never mind that I smoke for 30 years, for 1 year, doesn't matter. But from today onwards, I am a different person. If you say it to yourself with that level of energy, it is more likely that you can stop smoking. Yes, there will be a little bit of the cravings, etc., but that's why there are some methods. But some people just, they are so, they change totally the mindset into see it like that, and they just go through them. But you don't really need to suffer, and there are methods. You just need to ask expert advice from a session clinic. But if you just go to the session clinic, or like thinking, oh, it's not going to work for me, or no, I'm going to go back, then most likely it's not going to work. or you say, yes, I have decided from today onwards I'm not going to start smoking because I don't want to have a heart attack like my friend had, or I have a heart attack, I don't want to have a second heart attack because I don't know if I will survive the second heart attack. I was lucky to survive the first one. From today on, I'm going to stop smoking. If you say it with that level of energy, definitely, definitely, you are more likely to stop smoking. With other ones, it's not guaranteed, but with the other mentality, with the other things you're telling, while you're already thinking that you cannot do it, it's very likely that you are not going to be able to do it. And unfortunately, most patients approach this change like that. Either, and the same applies to any bad habit that you want to get rid of and improving your diet. If you say, I was saying to myself, now we're talking about diet, about this, I was saying to myself, I can do anything I want as long as I put my mind and actions into it, except controlling my diet. Imagine, with that belief, obviously, I was not able to control my diet, so that's why I was not controlling it. But when I discover and I say, oh, that's wrong, and that's what is stopping me to do it, the moment I say, yes, yesterday was like that, but from today onwards, I am a person on the path of losing weight, and I will do everything that a person on the path of losing weight is doing, definitely I'm going to lose weight, and that's what happened. By day 3, I already know that I was going to lose weight, eventually lost 10 kilograms, and have kept it for almost 3 years, but only because I decided to change my mindset. And then later, I just obviously use a good strategy to, you know, I do it gradually, targeted to the hot points. So not just going, okay, I'm going to lose weight, and I go to those crash diets that are circulating in Facebook, in Google, etc., and then can make you lose weight very fast, and then you just suffer, hate the diet, and just go back. No. So we do it in a clever, scientific, and medical-based way. So that's why we are proud to say that in my companies, we can help patients to do that. And if you apply the same principles of mindset to anything, it's going to work. And I just to make an analogy, so you say, oh, what this guy is talking about. So imagine if there's a football coach, if the football coach see the rival team coming up so strong, and they were the champions that season, and this is, and they say, oh my god, you know, guys, you know, that team has won 5 championships, you know, they just recruited that very good player, and you know, he scored 30 goals in last season, and I know, you know, we have only trained for 2 weeks. Oh, it's going to be a difficult game. I think, well, let's try our best to win it, no? You think that guy and that team is really going to win the game? Maybe they will lose it, but with that spirit, they are going to most likely lose the game. But if you say, oh guys, it doesn't matter, these guys are the champions, but imagine if today you were to defeat the champions, imagine how would you feel, what it mean to you. But I trust you can do it. Why? We have only trained this season for two weeks, but whatever we trained in the last year, just bring it on forward. Whatever I told you, put back today all your spirit. Put all your energy, leave everything on the field. If you do whatever is necessary to win this game, you can do it. I trust you can do it. And if we don't manage to lose, because indeed, that's a deserving opponent, but we lose doing all at our disposal. We lose proudly of ourselves. With which coach do you think that team is most likely to win, or most likely to feel better even if they don't manage to achieve the victory? So that's why mindset and the state, the way you tell things to your brain, the way you feel your brain, has got a lot of impact, or determines the actions you take and eventually what you receive. Now I'm applying that to your own care. If you just leave the things for the doctor to decide what to prescribe you, etc., and then you don't improve your diet and say, oh no, the doctor will decide for me, etc., you are just losing a big chunk of possibility to take good care of your disease and your health and your future and the future of your family, because your family might depend on you, if not economically, at least depend on having you around to love you and have experiences with you. So assume that responsibility of accountability on your care and start practicing more self-care. I'm not trying to be pushy, but I'm just trying to be frankly honest and motivate you in an active way. You cannot be passive about self-care. Self-care is about being active. The only thing you can obtain if you start practicing it is good. The things that can happen if you remain the same is keep it the same. If there are something bad, will remain bad or worse, because things tend to get worse through time. Complications tend to build through time. Diseases tend to get worse through time. Once you identify there is a problem, could be smoking, could be diet, could be control of certain problem, is the right time to start doing something differently. You don't know what to do, so that's why we doctors exist. Physios exist. Dietitians exist. Medical social workers exist. Support groups exist, etc. You don't need to do things solo. You have to practice self-care, but that doesn't mean that you need to know everything and do it solo. We are the guys giving you guidance or giving you strategies or empowering you to eventually just take better care of yourself solo. I hope you grasp me on that. Let me see, we have already 26 minutes. I think probably we can stop it today. I just want to give you a little more of comments, not just to be like a website, okay, it lose weight, eat better. It does. I want to tell you what is the principles behind all this, and also motivate you to do it, even sharing my own experience with I observe with my patients, or even my own experience. I told you I'm sharing that I was not losing weight, and because I was believing not able to lose weight, and eventually when I transformed that mindset into something positive and applying right strategies, I managed to do it, minimizing my disease risk crazily, and most likely, you know, prolonging my life if eventually I remain overweight, building risk for developing diabetes or diseases like that. No, that's what I want you to avoid, and I want my clients to avoid it. If they have risk for diabetes, have excessive weight, or if they have it, I want them to avoid complications. Or if they already have complications, I want them without complications to be more severe and turn into disability or worse, early death. So that's why I am so passionate, and all this is just my passion for you, to help you. That's it. So, I think we just leave it here because it's almost half an hour. So we will have still 15, as we go, depending on the pace that I believe is needed. So thank you for your support, guys. If you need my help, you know where to contact me. I have my clinic in Mount Elizabeth Novena Hospital in Singapore. You can also, you know, contact me online. As an option could be telemedicine. You can contact me. If you have something very general, you can just write it in the comment and I will just comment. But if it's something more specifically, probably you need to contact me separately, personally. And if it's you require my professional advice, it's ideal that you contract my services formally for, you know, your benefit, to give you exact advice, targeted, etc., professional advice. But if it is something general that you just have a doubt on these topics, just put it on the comment section and I will be happy to do it. You can do it later in the replay of this video. So I am Dr. Francisco, wishing you the best possible health. Take care. Bye bye.